Hey guys, Tyler here. So for this video, I'm going to react to two things from Spain, from this person from the Ministry of Equality. Now, as you guys can see right here, her name is Irene Maternal, and basically she is a super ultra feminist that's part of the Ministry of Equality. Now, for the first video, she's just stated out loud that the access of pornography is the main reason why people are raping each other. And I'm not even joking. This is what she said in this first video that I'm going to react to. And so what I'm going to do first, I'm going to pause and translate what she's saying in the video. That way, for those who don't understand Spanish, can understand the whole entire complicity of what she just said. And so, without further hesitation, let us react to the video. I'm going to put up the volume. And so, let's begin.
Cada vez más temprano hablamos de los 7-8 años.
Okay, so the access of pornography is getting younger and younger. It's around for 7 or 8 year olds.
De edad, si no hay educación sexual, ¿cómo vamos a prevenir las agresiones homófobas?
If there's no sexual education, how are we going to prevent the homophobic aggressions?
¿Cómo vamos a prevenir las violaciones, las agresiones sexuales?
How are we going to prevent, rape and sexual aggressions?
¿Cómo vamos a prevenir las relaciones que pueden terminar en dificultades para muchas mujeres?
How are we going to, end the hardships that women have to face in relationships? So, this whole entire thing is so weird to me because there are so many things that I have in my head. Now, first and foremost, it seemed to apply that homophobic aggressions against gay people is because of porn. Now, obviously, I don't think that's the case because if people want to really attack somebody just because they're gay, wouldn't it not be because they have hatred of gay people? Because if you actually attack somebody just because they're gay, that's evidence of a hate crime. And so, how in the world is pornography linked up with gay attacks or hate crimes? I don't understand the connection right here. The second thing it seemed to apply is that every single time somebody has porn, then it's not necessarily consensual. Now, I'm not gonna say that, of course, the porn industry is very clean. Obviously, there are probably a problem in every type of industry, right? But at the same time, for the most part, I think the majority of the parties that participate in porn actually do some sort of consent when it comes down to recording it. And so obviously the actor, the actresses, or whatever parties, they have some sort of consent, they have some sort of contracts they have to sign before they actually film their adult movie. Now, it's interesting that she mentioned, of course, that porn is the main reason why there's so many aggressions that's been going on in Spain. But I actually have some data that's been really interesting about the safest countries in the entire world. Now, this comes directly from this site right here. It lists the 50 worst and safest country for solo female travel. A study of the world's most dangerous countries for women traveling alone reveals the good, the bad, and the ugly. Now, here's the chart right here. Now, it's like one is like the most dangerous for women, and the lower it gets is like the most safest for women. So let's start reading the chart. Now, at number one, of course, is South Africa, and it's like the most dangerous country. Number two is Brazil. Number three is Russia. Number four is Mexico. Number five is Iran. Number six is Dominican Republic. Number seven is Egypt. Number eight is Morocco. Number nine is India. Number 10 is Thailand. Number 11 is Malaysia. Number 12 is Saudi Arabia. 13 is Turkey, 14 is Argentina, 15 is Chile, 16 is Cambodia, and of course, 19 is the United States of America. That's pretty high. Now, all the other countries, of course, is like, you know, it gets really, really low and lower and low. Now, the safest country in the entire world for women, according to this data chart right here, is that it is actually Spain. Spain is the safest country for all women. Now, not only that, though, but it's also really interesting when you look into like the data, too, about the constitution for Spain. Because basically, Spain also allows women to have the same sort of rights as men. So let's go to the Constitution. This is an official translation from the Spanish government in English. And so it's actually as accurate as it actually can get. Now it says underneath, like, you know, Chapter 2 of Rights and Freedom, under Section 14, that Spaniards are equal before the law. It may not in any way be discriminated against on the account of birth, race, sex, religion, opinion, and any other personal, social condition or circumstance. So that means it's actually illegal to discriminate people on the basis of sex just because, of course, they happen to be a certain gender. Unfortunately, though, there has been like a lot of, you know, gender violent laws against men in Spain because they're not treated as equally as the women. At the same time, women are actually, you know, protected under the law for like many parts of Spain.
Yo creo que todas las culturas y todas las religiones.
I'm sorry, that was like, you know, really, really loud. I'm sorry, but it was like loading up. But this video right here, and again, I'm going to translate the video for you guys. This is about her actually comparing, like, you know, the plight of women in Afghanistan to, like, you know, what's happening in Spain. And so let's translate this video too, and then I'm going to get my thoughts afterwards.
Yo creo que todas las culturas y todas las religiones tienen.
All right, she says, I think all cultures and all religions have forms.
Formas. Y con diferentes niveles de.
With different levels of hardships, of violence, of being oppressed.
Dureza de esa violencia, de oprimir a las mujeres. De.
That oppress women to also, you know, discipline their bodies and oppress them.
Disciplinar sus cuerpos y de oprimirlas. Y eso pasa en Afganistán.
And this happens in Afghanistan, and like I said to you before, the access to the rights.
Y como te decía antes, ¿no? El derecho al acceso al derecho al empleo, a la educación.
Access to the right to employment, education, health, but also this happens in Spain.
A la salud, pero también pasa en España con unas tasas todavía.
There are still intolerant people of, like, you know, sexist murderers.
Tolerables de asesinatos machistas y todavía contabilizamos los asesinatos en el marco de la pareja o la expareja, pero.
So, yeah, basically, she's just going on and on how basically, like, you know, because there's, like, you know, spousal abuse, because of, like, you know, sexist people going after women. That's still evidence of, you know, Spain also being comparable to Afghanistan. Now, like I said before, Spain is actually ranked the safest country for women. Not just that, but also Spain also protects the rights for women. Now, when it comes down to, like, you know, Sharia-oriented countries or like terrorist groups like the Taliban, how do they actually, you know, treat their women? Now, according to, you know, like the Quranic sources and also the stuff that they use to justify their terrorism, basically women are, you know, seen as like, you know, one half of a man. And so that means they're not as equal as men underneath, you know, Islamic law. On top of that, they can also stone women to death according to like verses in the whole entire, like, you know, hadith. And on, not just that, though, but it's also encouraged in the Quran to, you know, beat your woman. And also they force like the woman to wear the hijab because according to them, if they don't have the hijab on, the men are prone to, you know, rape them. And so there's so much just inequality for like women when it comes down to Islamic countries. Now, the West is not perfect. I'm not going to say that the West is perfect. At the same time, there's a clear difference between a first world country and something that's been going on in Afghanistan or in the Middle East when they are ruled by Islamic law. To sit here and compare what's happening in those countries to, you know, what's happening in Spain is just silly. It's just so incredibly silly. But what do you guys think? Tell me in the comment section down below. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next video.